We like it small. It's small, but it has incredible performance in it.
That's what she said.
Michael, please.
If you like cheap games and softwares, check out... Let me rephrase that. If you like breeding, check out GVG Mall. Link is in the description.
It is absolutely wonderful to be here in Taipei, opening up the Computex press conference, and I have to really...
Hey guys, Hughes here, and welcome to my new video. So AMD had a presentation a few days ago at Computex, where they unveiled their new Navi RX 5000 GPU series, as well as new Ryzen 3000 CPU series. Today I'm gonna quickly go over all the information we've got, and of course tell you my 2 cents on this. First thing they unveiled was their new core-heavy EPYC CPUs.
What we see in our labs and in our customers' labs is we see up to twice the performance. Twice.
But I don't think many people are interested in that, so let's talk about new Ryzen CPUs. These are the first CPUs with 7 nanometers process size and PCIe 4.0 enabled. Here you can see the prices and specifications, except for their cache. 3700X and 3800X have 36 MB, while 3900X has 70 MB of cache. According to this, we should expect a 11 to 34% boost in performance with 3800X compared to 2700X. I found it rather impressive when they showed us a comparison between R7 3700X and i9 9900K in PUBG. Apparently FPS was about the same, which sounds awesome, but we'll see about that in July. By the way, another thing worth mentioning is that they achieved a 15% IPC uplift.
And so today, I'm happy to share with you that Zen 2 in the PC workloads actually achieves 15% IPC uplift. 15%, every percent counts. And the reason it counts is because IPC lifts all boats. All applications improve with IPC, whether you're talking about gaming or heavily threaded applications and so on and so forth.
But what does that mean, some of you may ask? While clock speed tells you how many cycles a CPU can complete in a second, IPC tells you how many tasks a CPU can conduct in each cycle. So IPC and clock speed are equally important. Now let's talk a bit about Navi. New series is called RX 5000 and it is based on a new RDNA architecture. It is also the first GPU to have a PCIe 4.0 enabled. They didn't reveal a lot of details, but they did show that in Strange Brigade, RX 5000 beats their competition, which is RTX 2070, by roughly 10%. It's launched in July and that's all we know for now. More details will be revealed on June 10th, 3 PM PST, when they will inform us on the price points, products, performance, and some new features. And it's also worth mentioning that PlayStation 5 will be powered by Navi and Zen 2. So, am I hyped or not? Of course I am. I'm a hardcore PC enthusiast. I get hyped every time some new hardware is announced, but more often than not, I end up being somewhat disappointed. This is all promising and shit, but let's wait for July.
Third gen Ryzen is amazing.
Well, if she said it. But what do you think? Well, feel free to leave a comment and let's start a good discussion. Before I end this video, I just wanna say that you can expect more of my stupid ass voice in the future, and that starting from this video are entire slideshow comparison videos. They won't disappear, they will just be much better. So subscribe and click on that bell so you don't miss out on any of them. And that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button if you enjoyed, and see you in the next one.